In this, a man, how to be a qudwa, one of the things is he has to learn how to deal with his wife. Sisters, may Allah reward them, and I'm sure we are exact same way to them. They not like brothers, and they when they're dealing with us, it's like, oh, he's not like sisters, he's different. You know. So unless you know the art of marriage, art of how to deal with women, you know, you will always run into that end. You will always run to a wall. Always, what's wrong with you? Use your logic. Allah give you muha. You know, Allah give you aql. Allah give you brain. Use it. You know. Wow. Here's this brother, subhanAllah. He was extremely upset. What happened? He found his wife and his children and his child in the same crib. So the mother, jazakallah khair, she said, I want to be with my baby. So she went to the crib of her little child and she got into the crib and he walked into the door and both of them are in the crib. And he said, are you crazy? How old are you? What are you doing? You know how much this crib costs? $375. You're going to break it. See, it's not how they think. It's like, oh, my baby, she can't sleep. Well, he can't sleep. I'll be with you. I'll come. So unless you know how to deal with them, and say, oh, she's in a crib with a baby. And you say to your brothers, oh, my God. And you call, the lady just lost her mind. She's in a crib with a child. You know, you're the one who recommended her to me. What's wrong with you? You have to understand they're completely different. So you need to understand that you need to correct them with mawadda wa rahma. With mawadda, with love and compassion. And the way you correct is also an art itself. Also, form a qudwa is to be like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Didn't he correct Aisha with gentleness when she cursed the Yahud? Like they were cursing the Messenger of Allah? He cursed her. He corrupted her with gentleness. Also, you as a husband, you have to show, you have to help the wife around the house. Let's say you say, well, I want my house to be clean. You gotta be a person who's also trying to clean once a while. You gotta clean the house. And this is the Messenger of Allah. What did he do with his wife when he comes home? He used to sweep the floor. Are you better than the Messenger of Allah? Answer is, no answer from the brothers, of course, except the one who say no. So it's like, I don't know. I have internet, never had internet, you know. You're not better than the Messenger of Allah. So if he used to help his wife at home, then you should try to help her around the house. So be a qudwa. Yani, even when the Messenger of Allah said to the Sahaba, let us build the masjid. First masjid. Did he say, I am the mastermind. I'm the man who gives instructions. I receive wahi min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so I don't really make any mistakes. I'm going to chill here. I'm going to sit here and watch you guys how to design the masjid. Please keep get to work. Or did he participate helping building the masjid? He participated. He was carrying the bricks. He was, you know, mixing the mud and water. He was all he was part of the action. He was not missing in action. He was part of the action. So when it comes to the household, well, you got to be part of the action too. You got to learn how to cook. You got to learn how to clean. You got to be a father to your wife. You got to be a psychiatrist to your wife. For your wife, you got to be a brother. You got to be a friend. You got to be a companion. Because sometimes she needs to relieve all these thoughts, all these crazy ideas, all this. She wants to talk. She wants to. You got to be there with your ears listening to your wife. Also, a time of hardship and difficulties. Husbands, they have to be with their wife. Like what, ya ikhwati fillah? He's like, I'm providing for the family. I'm taking care of the financial aspect of the family. She doesn't work. What difficulties and hardships she's experiencing? I go and work with the kuffar. I, mashallah, I go and I deal with this, you know, boss of mine, and she just sits home and enjoys herself and sleeps with the kids. When the kids are taking nap and she gets up late, I have to get up for 1 by 8 o'clock and she gets up at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Not necessary. When, for example, if your wife is pregnant, if the wife is pregnant, most of the sisters, they're not in the right frame of mind. They're not. So when your wife is pregnant, if she says jump, don't say why. Just say, how high, honey? That's it. Seriously. Because if you try to challenge that, you're done, you're doomed. Because her herself cannot understand herself. A lot of young people who get married and they bounce back from the marriage and they get divorced is because it's like, wow, when I got married to this lady, before marriage she was beautiful, she was this. After marriage, mashallah, with the first few months she was pregnant and she lost her mind. That lady is crazy. She wants to eat pizza every single day. You know, I'm sick and tired of eating pizza. This is their nature. At that time, I know a sister, subhanAllah. I knew a sister who used to buy this chemical. It's a chemical, nasty, you know, chemical. And she was like, smelling that chemical. And the whole house stinks. And the guests like, you have a mice, something died in the house. But to her, this is the best smell ever. What would you do as a husband? You say, out of your mind, lady. Let's see a doctor. No, this is who she is at that moment. If you really videotape your wife at that time, and you play that videotape later when she comes back to her senses, she delivers a child, she'll be like, oh my God, I did that. There was a sister also. She can smell her husband for miles. If he sends a gift to someone else, he will say, my husband touched this. No. For 9 months, she cannot stand her husband. She cannot see him. He stinks to her. You know, no matter what he does, she can. For 9 months, the man is out. And as soon as she delivers the baby, where's my husband? I miss my husband. As soon as the baby is out, she misses her husband. And then husband's like, no more children. But you don't deal with your wife with that capacity in that stage. You have to learn how to deal with it. So this is a difficult time for her. Sometimes some sister, during her monthly cycle, they go through the same thing. And 8 to 15 days of the month, you're in that cycle. Yani, subhanAllah. What Mughira ibn Shu'bah used to say, and this is a good sister, I'm not going to like it, but he used to say, A man who has one wife, when his wife is in her menses, he is in his menses. When she's pregnant, he's pregnant. When she's suckling her child, he's suckling her child. Because to them, okay, you know, okay, assalamu alaikum, that's a second wife, third wife, fourth wife. You know, there was option, but here you have no option. So when your wife is pregnant, it's a difficult time, you live with that and make sure you understand her feeling. What's the next point? Women are nothing but about feelings. I was feeling like this. This was how I feel. This is all about feelings most of the time. So if you're not well equipped and not educated enough about the feelings of women's feelings, then you will be lost. You and I, sometimes we rationalize things. Akhi, I don't like you really. I don't like your behavior. I don't like your attitude. I don't like the way you look. But hey, we can work together. It's given. Sisters, no. It's not like, I don't like anything and everything that comes with you. You should not even exist. It's about feeling. So husband, the brothers who wants to be a role model for their wife, he also have to understand that from his wife and say, subhanAllah.
other thing is,